Today's winners and losers on Wall Street with our financial expert, Rob Black. And it seems the economy is improving. We had good news on GDP growing at 3.6%. And is Christmas trees, are Christmas trees a sign of an improving economy?
I guess so.
It seems like it.
Yeah, so we're seeing Christmas trees up 16% in sales in the first week, up 7% last year. So go out and get a Christmas tree because someone is mysteriously shopping and buying up all the Christmas trees. Other parts of retail not working terribly well. Apparel not doing well at all, but the Home Depot's of the world doing fine, and Christmas trees in high demand. So I guess we're feeling cheerier and merrier this year.
That's good news. So is the Ford Motor Company. The U.S. auto industry seems to be alive and well once again. And here's a great example, the new Ford Mustang being unveiled. This is a beautiful car.
Yeah, and I'm not much of a car enthusiast, so I'm not great at talking about this kind of stuff. It's 50 years old. To give you perspective, when it came out, the Beatles were just getting popular. Kodak was introducing the photo film, and things have changed, but the Mustang remains the same. It's an iconic product for Ford. It's called a pony car, which the Camaro has taken the mantle and passed from it, which has to make Ford crazy because they were the original pony car. I dated a girl who had a 69 racing Mustang, and it was one of the best girlfriends in my life.
I can't believe you broke up with her.
Romantically speaking, it was great.
Beautiful car.
But with that said, 26% of buyers are women of Ford Mustangs.
Wow, beautiful looking vehicle.
Yep.
Let's talk about the fast food debate. And Rob and I were even talking about this earlier, and it is a big debate across the nation, and we're seeing 100 cities with fast food workers going out on strike demanding better wages. And there is this big argument, Rob, about whether or not the living wage is affordable for businesses and whether or not it can be done in this country.
Yeah, and we're talking about unskilled, typically undereducated, not uneducated, but undereducated. We're talking about a debate where you were like, yeah, have McDonald's go ahead and pay the higher wages, but it's not McDonald's that pays the higher wages, it's the franchisees. And you were like, McDonald's made $6 billion last year. Mm-hmm. But that's the corporation that sells the food to the franchisees. It's not an easy debate to fix. I myself, and for the record, Yahoo did an ad today, a survey. 63% say don't raise minimum wage, 27% say yes. So the majority of Americans say don't do it. With that said, you know, obviously it's a frustrating thing to see. $7.25 an hour is $15,000 a year for full-time work. When I was young, McDonald's was a way to get out of the house, meet a girl, kiss a girl, get ready for college. It wasn't meant to be a job. You know, people like Dave Letterman go, you know, you want fries with that, as a way of making fun of the, you know, the job per se. Democrats are pushing for higher minimum wage. It'll be an interesting 2014. I say look at countries like Greece, Argentina, Cuba, and Hugo Chavez land. We don't want to go down that way. We don't want to unionize fast food. I say look at countries, Hong Kong and Singapore, cities that don't have a minimum wage, that are thriving on a free market system. For free markets to work, though, you have to be educated. And for cost of education soaring, it's tough to be educated.
And certainly an interesting debate. We'll see as this movement begins to grow for higher wages for fast food workers.
And let the haters come out on Facebook. I know I just said I don't support minimum wage.
Well, there's people on both sides of the argument. One interesting note, though, UC Berkeley's Institute of Industrial Relations did a study that the 44,000 Walmart workers in California receive $86 million a year in health care, food stamps, and other subsidies. So there's also the argument that we as taxpayers are paying to support these workers.
There's also an argument that why are they the number one retailer? Because we go and support them.
Right.
If you want to help your local economies, go shop locally. Don't shop at Walmart. It's the consumers that make the mistake, in my mind.
All right. Interesting debate.
Yep.
All right. Let's talk about Heidi Montag and Spencer Pratt. These were the stars of the Hills. And here's a really cautionary tale. You always advise us how to save money. They blew through $10 million.
Yeah. Bankrupt, living at home, getting ready to come out with a new show. I bring this up because, yeah, they had $10 million, but they were doing $4,000 bottles of wine. She was shopping $30,000 a day. $30,000 on plastic surgery. 20-somethings make the same mistake. They're getting $40 bottles of wine. They're doing plastic surgery. They're spending, they're shopping, they're consuming. The lesson learned is in your 20s, don't be a consumer.
I love their quote. We thought we were Jay-Z and Beyonce. Thank you, Rob. Yep. We'll be right back as the Crown 4 Morning News continues. You can catch Rob Black segments on our app as well as on our evening news as well.